Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names.
To college basketball here on ESPN Plus, Presbyterian and Elon here in Clinton, South Carolina. There you see the first offensive possession for the Phoenix goes unheralded. They turn the ball over, pass out of bounds, as now Presbyterian takes over on the offensive end. They'll try to work it down inside to McCormack. His shot won't go. Fought for underneath by Elon to go out of bounds. And it'll belong to the Blue Hose as we're underway here in Clinton, South Carolina, the Templeton Center. I'm Tyler Sugar. Happy Thursday afternoon, early nooner tip here on ESPN Plus for the Blue Hose and the Phoenix. Presbyterian. It's Crosby James going to go inside, puts up a jumper off the side of the rim, no good. And Elon with the rebound. Both of these teams coming in with just two wins on the season. Elon 2-8 overall. Presbyterian 2-9. Both teams looking for win at number three on the season as Pratt goes inside and trying to get a layup. He can't get it to go. Presbyterian will have the rebound. There's Barnett. He'll pass off to Terrell Ard. Ard goes inside. He rolls one off his fingertips, but it won't fall. And Elon has that rebound. So nothing going so far offensively for both of these teams as Hollerin will go inside and pass it back out to Hollerin. It goes behind his back. The pass over to Sherry. They'll come back outside. McKinnon inside the lane. Spins, puts up a jumper. And the floater goes for Elon, and they're up 2-0. Elon with the first basket of the game, nearly 2 minutes in. Crosby James attempts a jumper from 3 points in the corner, no good. Elon has the rebound. A little full court pressure now from the Blue Hose. Able to break it and gets it out to McKinnon. McKinnon looking for the entry pass, goes inside to Sam Sherry, and he'll lay one in, and the lead is 4 for the Phoenix. Marquise Barnett has it poked out from behind, fight on the floor. Presbyterian still has it, but now taken away by McKinnon. He'll throw it ahead to Holland. Holland for 3. And he buries it, and it's out quickly. A 7-0 lead for Elon here in this ballgame on Thursday afternoon. Presbyterian trying to settle in. Reddish rolling to get a touch. Trying to facilitate the offense. It's to Barnett, who comes back. They'll go down inside to McCormack. He can't get the one from close in to go, and it'll be a toss ahead for Elon, and the Presbyterian faithful wanted a walk, not going to get it. But the shot no good, and Art Jr. into the offensive side. He'll pass it off to Crosby James. He'll shoot for 3. He'll air ball it right into the arms of the Elon defender. Pratt, who goes all the way to the other end, his finger roll won't go, but an offensive rebound by Elon. Now McKinnon going inside, off the glass and good. And it's a 9-0 run to start this game for Elon. Not the start Presbyterian was looking for in this one. As we're nearly 4 minutes into this contest and they don't have a bucket. Reddish wrong, going to bounce, pass it into Ard. Ard gets into a little trouble in the lane. They're going to get a whistle and an offensive foul called on Terrell Ard Jr. as it takes us in to our first media timeout with 15:55 left to go in the first half. It's a 9-0 Elon lead here at the Templeton Center. We'll be right back.
Hard work, a love for the game, is mandatory down here. Sacrifice, a desire to be great, lives down here. Excellence, the will to compete, persists down here. This is the Big South, where winners are made.
Citywide to countryside. Whatever you drive, wherever you go, Hercules Tires has the value, selection, and industry-leading protection to get you there, no matter where the road takes you. Hercules Tires, ride on our strength.
Last year, I had more blood and platelet transfusions than I can count. During my treatment for acute T-cell lymphoblastic lymphoma, the chemotherapy took a toll over my body. And one of the main things that helped me survive was my routine blood transfusions. Blood donors keep cancer patients like me fighting every day. Sign up now at thebloodconnection.org/donate.
Back here with you at Templeton Center Presbyterian College. 9-0 Elon lead here to start this one in our first media timeout. There you see Elon's head coach, Billy Taylor, in his first season at the helm for the Phoenix out of the Colonial Athletic Conference. As we had a little remote control race here at the first media timeout. Today, Education Day here on campus. Got a lot of elementary, middle school students here from the Clinton area in the stands, and they're seeing an Elon team who's come out firing pretty good and up 9-0 with 15:55 left to play here in the first half. Let's see what kind of changes Coach Quentin Farrell, the Presbyterian, makes here at the first media timeout. As you see some folks coming back out, it'll be Kobe Stewart in the game. He'll replace Terrell R., the only change for Presbyterian on the floor. As we come back out of this media timeout, 9-0 Elon lead, and Elon has the basketball here to start out of this timeout. Torrance Watson passes it off to Hollerin. John Hollerin, the graduate out of Orlando, Florida. McKinnon, a step back three, grazes the front of the rim, and Crosby James has the rebound for Presbyterian. James going to go coast to coast, try to get the first bucket for Presbyterian, but it's swatted out of there. A block by McKinnon. And they'll have it taken the other way, and they'll tie it up in the lane, and we're going to get a jump ball call. The alternating possession will give it back to Presbyterian. We'll take another look here. We'll go back. Crosby James looks like he's going to have a bucket, but no. Max McKinnon, the freshman out of Brisbane, Australia, has other thoughts. He gets it on the offensive end, gets it tied up. And it goes to Presbyterian on the jump ball. Here's Reddish Roan, who will go inside. He can't get the bucket to go, but he's able to draw the foul. And Trayvon Reddish Roan going to head to the line for a couple of free throws. A senior out of Carrollton, Georgia. Transferred from the College of Charleston. You see the foul there. So Reddish Roan going to give a chance, going to have a chance to get Presbyterian their first points of the game. Coming from the free throw stripes, he'll toe the line for the first. It's too strong off the iron. And the Blue Hose remain scoreless. more coming for the senior. And it's too strong off the iron. He missed them both. We're going to have a foul called on the Presbyterian on Reddish Roll. And we'll take another look at that. See what happened there. Going to get him for a hold.
Checking in for the Blue Hose, number 10.
And Reddish Roll will head to the line, and James LaVorne will check in.
Also setting in for the Phoenix, number 4,
Sam Sherry going to check back in also for Elon. It's a 9-0 Elon lead, under 15 minutes left to play in the first half. Blue Hose still looking for their first points of the game. Right now, Elon on the offensive end. Halloran going to go inside, dumps it down. A whistle and a foul as he tried to get it in. Did Sam Sherry. But instead, he'll draw the foul ahead to the free throw stripe for two. As you see, a good pass. And there's the foul. On Marquise Barnett, his first. So Sherry toes the line. Chance to extend the lead, and he rattles down the first one. One more coming for Sherry. Sophomore. Too strong off the back iron. Presbyterian has the rebound. As McCormack able to clear that one out, pass it off to Barnett. LaVorne be up top, running the offense. Gets it to Barnett. Barnett for three. In and out, no good. And the rebound to Elon, leading 10-0. Halloran for three. In and out, no good. Presbyterian with the rebound. LaVorne going to walk across the baseline, tosses it back out to Stewart, has it knocked away. McCormack, though, able to track it down. And they'll get it back to Crosby. James. James has it tied up, and it's going to be taken away. A steal by the Phoenix going to the other end. There's a shot up, no good. A whistle and a foul. And it's Torrance Watson tried to go to the bucket. Let's take another look at that whole progression. Collering does a good job getting it away from Crosby James to throw it up. And then there's the foul, the swipe across the arms.
At the line shooting two, it's Torrance Watson.
And now Torrance Watson to the line, the senior out of St. Louis, Missouri. Hits the first.
Selling in for the Phoenix, number 33, John Bowen. And for the Blue Hose, number 5, Houston Jones. And number 13, Terrell R. Jr.
Houston Jones and Terrell Ard check in for Presbyterian. As Watson has one more free throw coming, that one on the way, and it rattles down. So a 12-0 lead for Elon. 13:50 left to play in the first half. Bounce pass into Stewart. Stewart, jumper. Can't get it to fall. Gets the put back, and there it is. The first points of the game. For Presbyterian, come with 13:41 left to play in the first half. We got a whistle and a foul away from the basketball.
Presbyterian foul on number 5, Houston Jones.
The foul is going to be on Houston Jones. And there you see the first Presbyterian bucket of this game. 13:42 left to play in the first half. Hollering tries to go inside, put one off the glass, no good, knocked out of bounds by Elon. So Presbyterian starts the game 1 of 10 from the field. Where I come from, that's like 10%. Elon a not much better, 4 for 10 to start the contest. LaVorne going to go inside, loses the handle on it, turns it over. Oh, throws it across. Three-point attempt by number 33, John Bowen III. He knocks it down. Transfer from UNC Wilmington. Jones going to put up a three, in and out, no good. Rebound fault for underneath. Ard has it. He'll go back up off the glass and good. And we got a whistle underneath, but the basket counts, and it's 15-4 as we take another look at this one. Ard goes up. He's able to get the basket to fall. And underneath the big man, number four, Sam Sherry. Looks like maybe he got hit in the eye. Pace rubs those eyes and now goes over to see the trainer over on the Elon bench. Hopefully he'll be okay and be ready to re-enter here in just a second as Elon gets the ball in to Haller. Watson for three. Off the front of the rim, no good. Stewart goes up, has the rebound. Stewart takes it the other end, passes out to Crosby James. James for three. Off the back iron, no good. And a rebound quickly by the Phoenix. Fired away ahead, up underneath the basket, and there's going to be a turnover. Ball goes out of bounds. Looked like it was last touched by Presbyterian. But they'll award the ball to Elon. Let's take another look at it here. It's underneath, they try to pass it back out. I don't know if it was tipped. The referee wasn't sure either. He made a decision. And they'll go with it. Ard inside tries a floater. Can't get it to fall. Presbyterian struggling from the field, just shooting 14%, 2 of 14. From the field so far, Elon 5 for 12 from the field, 2 for 5 from beyond the arc. Nearly a turnover there by the Phoenix, but inside, off the glass, no good. And the rebound pulled down by Stewart, and he's going to be fouled, and that'll carry us to a media timeout. An 11-point advantage for Elon, leading 15-4, 11:24 to play in the first half. We'll be right back on ESPN+.
This is a personalized ad. It helps you find good ideas. This is Jada, who found one. And here's Greg, badly in need of a good idea. You see, you can discover a small business at any moment. Oh, look, it's that moment when a good idea helps make a moment a better moment. You get the idea. Good ideas deserve to be found. Personalized ads help you find them.
Sometimes the finish line is just beyond that guy from the gym, Taylor. Or is it Tyler?
Just 10 seconds left. Martinez!
Back here with you at Presbyterian College, 15-4, Elon lead over the Blue Hose. There you see, well, sometimes, maybe, in a minute, you'll see Quentin Farrell, head coach of the Presbyterian College Blue Hose, in his fourth season as the head coach here at his alma mater. Trying to get some offense going for the Blue Hose. Oh, there's Coach Farrell. Trying to get some offense going for the Blue Hose here in the first half. It has been a struggle, 2 of 14 from the field for the Blue Hose. Just 4 points here in the early going. 0 for 5 from outside and 0 for 2 from the free throw stripe. So not at all the offensive starts you want if your coach, Quentin Farrell, over on the bench for Presbyterian. But it's Presbyterian ball as we get out of this media timeout. 11:24 again left to go in the first half, and it's a 15-4 lead for Elon. Stewart to LaVorne. McCormack, who has been a catalyst for this team this year, gets it inside to Reddish Roan, who they want to be the catalyst for this team, and he misses a jumper. Elon has the rebound. Nearly a takeaway by Houston James. Eight to shoot, inside, up off the glass, no good. Shot blocked by Kobe Stewart. And Presbyterian going to take it down to the other end. Stewart going to go inside, go up, off the glass, off the rim, no good. Knocked around, Elon has it. Those players getting tangled up on the transition. Three-pointer from the corner for Elon is off the rim, no good. That was McKinnon, who misses that one from the left wing. Watson, bounce pass, down low to Sherry, McKinnon. Turnaround is no good. Reddish Roan inside for PC, tosses it back out. Three-point attempt for James LaVorne, and he knocks it down, and it's 15-7. Presbyterian closes the gap, gets it to within single digits. Looks inside, gets it down low to Watson. Watson can't get the close range shot to go. Able to get it back, and they're going to wave it off and say there was a foul on the floor. If we go back and look at this first three-pointer by Presbyterian, LaVorne knocks down the three. Sean Halloran going to check back in, and Sam Cherry checks back in. And there, another look at the foul. Keeps it with Presbyterian. We're going to have another one. This one going to be on Reddish Roan. That'll be his second here in the first half. And it will send Max McKinnon to the line for a 1-1. 17th foul on the Blue Hose. The front end is good, so McKinnon will have one more. And knocks down both of his free throws to extend the lead back to 10 for the Elon Phoenix. Presbyterian in the half court offense. LaVorne gets it to Stewart. Stewart going to come back out to LaVorne. He's going to try another three, and he finds nothing but the bottom of the net. He's back-to-back threes for James LaVorne. Makes it a seven-point game, and now he almost has a takeaway on the other end, trying to get it done on both ends of the court, but knocks it out of bounds, and it'll stay with Elon. So check out this three again from pretty deep. LaVorne showing the range. Makes it a 17-10 ball game. So as bad as Presbyterian shot here in the first half, just within seven right now, just shooting 22.2%. Elon just a little north of that at 29.4. There's a three-point attempt by Halloran. His shot won't go. He didn't follow it, and it goes out of bounds. And it'll belong to the Blue Hose. Under 9 minutes to play in the first half. 7-point game. Stewart with the play call. Who's hit back-to-back threes, passes it out to James. James will give it up. He'll the three-point attempt by Houston Jones, and Presbyterian has hit three-pointers on their last three possessions and has cut the lead to four. 17-13, 8:20 to play, first half. By LaVorn. Going to take a step back three from deep. No good. Rebound out of bounds. It'll belong to Presbyterian when we come back. 7:58 left to go in this one. We got us a game. It's 17-13, a four-point advantage for Elon here on ESPN+.
The right way to top a sub is with real red wine vinegar made from red grapes and no food coloring. And the right way to film it is in slow motion. Obviously.
Hercules Tires has the value, selection, and industry-leading protection to get you there, no matter where the road takes you. Hercules Tires. Ride on our strength.
Last year, I had more blood and platelet transfusions than I can count. During my treatment for acute T-cell lymphoblastic lymphoma, the chemotherapy took a toll over my body. And one of the main things that helped me survive was my routine blood transfusions. Blood donors keep cancer patients like me fighting every day. Sign up now at thebloodconnection.org/donate.
There's not a secret to what actually happens behind the scenes at a bank. Here at First Citizens, we're trying to educate the client in each step of what's actually going to happen and actually have them make the educated decision around what steps and what options they utilize. We want to become that trusted advisor that actually guides them down that road, helping you reach your goals. That's Forever First.
The right way to top a sub is with real red wine vinegar made from red grapes and no food coloring. And the right way to film it is in slow motion. Obviously. Because authentic ingredients make a sub above.
Presbyterian down big in this one, but the three-pointer is the great equalizer. Presbyterian has gone on a 6-0 run over the last minute and 13 seconds, including those back-to-back-to-back three-point attempts, two of them by James LaVorn, and Presbyterian has closed the gap, and it's now 17-13, just a four-point game as we go under 8 minutes to play here from the Templeton Center Presbyterian College on a little afternoon basketball, midday basketball even, here on ESPN+. And this LaVorn gives it over to Crosby James, who can't get that three-pointer to go. And it'll go out of bounds and belong to Elon. Presbyterian shooting 33% from outside. 3 of 9 for the Blue Hose so far in this one. And it was on the previous three possessions. We're going to have a whistle underneath the basket, away from the basketball. Fouls on Houston Jones, his second. And the team's eighth, which means another 1-1 for Matt Kennan. McKinnon at the line. misses the front end. So the rebound by Presbyterian with the Blue Hose chance to close the gap even more. Inside to Ard. Ard going to go up and draw the foul. Terrell Ard Jr. going to head to the line for a couple of free throw opportunities. Fouls on Bowen.
And the team is third.
See it there, just a little bump.
At the line, shooting two, Terrell
second
Ard
foul
Jr.
for Bowen. Ard at the line. Misses the first off the back of the rim. One more coming for Ard. Redshirt sophomore out of Marietta, Georgia. Can't get that one to go either, but still a four-point game. Bounce pass taken away by Jones. Jones will bring it across himself before passing off to James. Three-pointer from McCormack, and he buries the three. And we got a one-point game here at Presbyterian. 17-16, the Blue Hose have come all the way back to trail just by one. Before the first half, Ard going to knock that pass away out of bounds. We take another look at the three-pointer from Owen McCormack. Big man getting it done. Pulling the Blue Hose to within one with 6:33 to play in the half. Halloran going to go inside underhand. Puts the Phoenix back up three, 19-16. Three-pointer, keeping Presbyterian in this ball game so far. As James going to go in and try to bank one off the glass, no good. Rebound, tapped out to LaVorn, down to McCormack. Get it to James again. And Presbyterian back up top. Ard, have it stripped away, but there's a foul. He's going to call it on the floor.
Elon foul on number zero, Sean.
That's on Sean Hollering, his first foul. And LaVorn will inbound. We're going to have a whistle and an offensive foul on Presbyterian on Owen McCormack. His first. Let's see if we can see what he did there. Yeah, the push. Yeah, they'll get you for that. Definitely get you for that. My usual colleague, KB, would disagree, but you know. It's usually what he does. Hollering all the way across court, then they'll come back up top. Bounce pass down low, and the slam by the big man, Sam Sherry, flushes it down to put Elon back up five. Side to Ard. Ard has it poked out from behind. Elon slows it down. Pass ahead to Irvin. Three-pointer from Watson from the corner. And it's good. And Presbyterian got it to within one. And now it's back up to an eight-point advantage for the Phoenix. LaVorn for three from way outside. It bounces around, won't go. McCormack with the rebound, put back, no good. The whistle and the foul. And a little extracurricular activity underneath.
Let's
take another look how Elon's been able to extend this lead. A little slam. And a three, a 5-point swing there. If I'm not mistaken, When Owen McCormick got fouled right there, he chest bumped the defender. Getting a little emotional. Good stuff. Fun stuff. 4:40 left to go as McCormack will go to the line. He misses the first. Kobe Stewart's going to check back in for Presbyterian. McCormack makes the second. Now a 7-point game. 24-17. 4:35 to play in the first half. And we got a whistle again away from the basketball. It's going to be on Houston Jones, and I believe that's going to be his third. Take a look at it here as he's on the, going to be on the baseline. He vehemently disagreed with the call. His opinion doesn't count. As Watson goes to the line for two, hits the first. 10th foul on Presbyterian, gives Elon the double bonus the rest of the half. Terrell Ard will check in for Houston Jones. Watson second, rattles but goes. Game throws it across to LaVorn. LaVorn working it down all the way back across to Stewart. Stewart goes inside the three-point line, puts up a jumper, it's no good. Whistle and a foul. Going to be on Elon's number four, Sam Sherry. They say he hooked and held Owen McCormack. Take another look. See, there's the arm behind the back. That's what drew the whistle.
Elon fouls on number four, Sam Sherry. That's his first in the team.
That's Sherry's first. And just Elon six with 4:13 to go in the half. Presbyterian basketball, LaVorn will inbound. Gets it into Ard. Ard going to go up. Can't get the shot to go, but the whistle and the foul. Terrell Ard Jr. going to be headed to the line once again. Ard so far 0 for 2 from the free throw stripe today. As you see him going inside.
Terrell Ard Jr.
And Ard airballed it, which is rare on a free throw for anybody. Second one, short as well, grazes the front part of the rim. Elon able to track down the rebound. 4 minutes now left to play in the first half. Elon with a 9-point lead, 26-17. McKinnon tosses it across. 3-point attempt by Sean Holleran, and he knocks it down for three. And the Elon lead is now 12. James up top for three, and he'll answer. The three-pointer by Holleran, answered by Crosby James, and back to a 9-point game. Irvin going inside, back out to Holleran. Holleran going to back it out and reset the offense. Holleran has it taken away. Well, loose ball still. Holleran able to track it down, gets it to Watson. Watson going to go inside. Shot blocked. Going to go inside, and we got us a shot clock violation. As we head to commercial break, the three-pointer working for both of these teams. Shooting 40% plus from beyond the arc today as we head to our final media timeout here on ESPN+.
Did you know one of Nissan's EVs survived the North Pole? And one can go 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds.
And they're all emission free. But don't get an EV for the E. Get it because it pins you to your seat. Sparks your imagination and takes your breath away. Nissan EVs aren't just electric. They electrify you.
This is a personalized ad. It helps you find good ideas. This is Jada, who found one. And here's Greg, badly in need of a good idea. You see, you can discover a small business at any moment. Oh, look, it's that moment when a good idea helps make a moment a better moment. You get the idea. Good ideas deserve to be found. Personalized ads help you find them.
Just take it slow. Slow, slow.
Mom?
Wow.
Wow.
And we'll check them both for free.
Yes.
Fix Finder, the most complete free warning light report backed by technician-verified fixes.
The moment you dreamed of has arrived. Introducing the Kleinfeld Collection. Exclusive styles at Zales. The Diamonds.
Back here with you at Templeton Center, Presbyterian College. Elon has now extended their lead to 29-20, 2:56 left to play in the first half here in Clinton, South Carolina. Leading scorer for the Elon Phoenix. It would be number zero, Sean Hollerin, has 8 points. McKinnon has 6, Watson with 7, and Sam Sherry has 5. For Presbyterian, leading scorer is James LaVorn, who has 6 points on a couple of three-pointers back-to-back. But there you see the leading scorer from both sides, Sean Hollerin, the 6-foot, 160-pound graduate student out of Orlando, Florida, transferred in from Belmont Abbey, leading this Elon team here this afternoon. As we wind down time here in the first half. Presbyterian on the offensive end, where they are shooting just 28% from the field, but 41.7% from outside the arc. Here in this ballgame, we got another foul underneath, away from the basketball. It's going to be on number 3. Max McKinnon. His first freshman out of Brisbane, Australia. So Ard goes to the line 0 for 4 from the stripe. And he got that one. Front end of the 1-1 as a Elon player goes to the floor. He's now grabbing at his leg. See if he's all right. May have come down on something funny. That's Torrance Watson. Let's see if we can see what happened to him. Yeah, got his foot a little tangled with Owen McCormack. Nord will check in his place. Hopefully he's all right and he'll be able to return. One more coming for Ard, and he makes them both. Sam Sherry checks back in. For Elon. Allen gets it over to RJ Nord. He'll hit his first shot of the game on his first attempt after just checking in. McCormack for 3 from the corner. And Owen McCormack hits his second three-pointer of the game. Bold Presbyterian within 6. court up top. Back over to McKinnon. McKinnon working against Kobe Stewart. Goes inside, nearly has it knocked away, but instead go up underneath and get the shot to fall. LaHorn calls the play for Presbyterian. Touch pass into Ard. Ard from the lane has it stripped away. They're going to get a whistle and a foul. It's going to be on number zero. Hollering is second. And that'll put Ard at the line again. Two more free throws. Two for six so far. Make him 3 of 7. One more coming. Leaves that one a little bit short. Bizarre. Hollering on the offensive end. 1 minute left to play in the first half. Forward up top to Sherry, who hands it back off to Urban. They'll go inside to Sherry. He'll get the shot to go with a little contact. And we're going to get a whistle, and I believe a technical foul. We will get a technical foul on Sherry. Let's take another look at it. See what he did there. It's that one to go. I believe they got him with a little taunting there. So, and McCormack will go to the line. Things have been a little chippy down low between those two. Things have been a little chippy. So the referee's just trying to get a little bit of control on that. And it'll give Sherry a technical foul. And McCormack hits both of the technical free throws. And Presbyterian, I believe, going to ask for a timeout. Timeout, Presbyterian, 46.1 to go, 35-28. Look at some of the numbers here. Presbyterian started off this game abysmal from the floor. They were shooting just terrible to start this game, and it's improved some for the Blue Hosts, 8 of 26 from the field. 30.8%, where on the other side, Elon, 12 of 27 from the field, shooting 44.4%. Both teams shooting fairly well from outside. Presbyterian 6 of 13, 46.2%, and Elon 4 of 10 for 40%. Presbyterian not hitting their free throws with the best consistency. It's 6 of 14 for 42.9%, whereas Elon is 7 of 9 for 77.8% so far. And a 7-point lead for the Phoenix with 46.1 seconds to play here in the first half from the Templeton Center here at Presbyterian College. LaVorn will take the inbound pass across the half-court stripe. Presbyterian goes into their offense. LaVorn for three. Off the back rim, no good. Rebound out of bounds. And he'll say last touch by Presbyterian. Kobe Stewart disagreed with that call. But the shot clock is off. Elon can hold it for the last shot of the half. Up by 7. Oliver with 5 to shoot, goes inside to McKinnon. McKinnon comes back out to Urban. Urban going to go inside, put up a floater, no good. And that will end the first half of play here from the Templeton Center. Your score, Elon 35, Presbyterian 28. Halftime stats and highlights all on the way next on the Halftime Report here on ESPN+. We'll be right back.
Did you know one of Nissan's EVs survived the North Pole? And one can go 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds. And they're all emission-free. But don't get an EV for the E. Get it because it pins you to your seat.
Sparks your imagination. And takes your breath away. Nissan EVs aren't just electric. They electrify you.
Take it slow. Slow, slow.
Mom?
Wow.
Wow.
And they'll check them both for free.
Yes.
Fix Finder, the most complete free warning light report backed by technician verified fixes.
With Metro.
Imagine even more savings and more video. Calling, more sharing every memory. So happy together.
Choose from the largest selection of free 5G phones only at Metro.
Our Fairbanks, Alaska store is closest to the North Pole, which has folks wondering, does Santa shop at the Home Depot?
No comment.
No comment.
No comment. There's a lot of Nicks in this town.
Somebody made the naughty list.
These tiny gloves are the most popular. We don't know why.
It's elves.
Come on, Bryce.
Find everything you need to make the holidays yours, and maybe Santa?
Santa! I'm Keith.
At the Home Depot, how doers get more done.
I've never seen a big guy wear flip-flops.
Loving you is where it's at. You made me so very happy. I'm so glad you came into my life.
The Silver Line now has 6 new stops, including Dulles Airport. It's the easy way to connect.
Surprise!
With the ones you love.
This Big South broadcast is brought to you in part by Hercules Tires. Ride on our strength. Visit HerculesTires.com. Sunbelt Rentals, we have equipment for that. First Citizens Bank, Forever First, and Jersey Mike's, a sub above. Hercules Tires is the official tire of the Big South Conference for over 65 years. Has been providing tires with unbeatable quality at an unmatched value, whatever the vehicle. And whenever the terrain, Hercules Tires invites you to ride on our strength for a retailer near you, visit HerculesTires.com. Get social with the Big South. Join the always growing network of Big South fans on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and more. Keep up with the latest news or interact with the league and its fans. Follow, watch, like, and share with the Big South Conference. 35-28 here at the half. Elon with the lead over Presbyterian. We got first half stats and highlights on the other side of the break. We'll be right back here on ESPN+.
Did you know one of Nissan's EVs survived the North Pole? And one can go 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds.
And they're all emission-free. But don't get an EV for the E.
Get it because it pins you to your seat.
Sparks your imagination.
and takes your breath away. Nissan EVs aren't just electric. They electrify you.
You can feel confident Continental is the smart choice in tires.
Can they handle extremes?
Yep. Tested from the Texas desert to near the Arctic Circle.
Really?
Really.
Anything for the guy who finds that one pothole?
Yeah. Road hazard coverage has your back.
For real?
Absolutely.
Were they made by, like, a bajillion engineers?
Well, closer to 100. Continental. Welcome to the smart choice in tires.
With Metro.
Imagine even more savings in ball video. Calling, more sharing every memory. So happy together.
Choose from the largest selection of free 5G phones. Only at Metro.
Be back in a sec.
We can't wait forever.
Call your nacho friend, please.
Made with Mexican spices. Made for nacho cheese sauce. Only at Taco Bell.
You didn't come to work out. You came to outwork. Let's get it.
Yo. Boom.
Come on, you got this.
Everyday man's on the block.
Hey, no challenge, no change.
The ting goes.
Let's go.
Get $400 off Peloton packages. Terms apply.
Wow. I love it.
Game,
yes!
Set, match.
Score low prices and great deals at Target. Get low prices on holiday lights, stocking stuffers, wrapping paper, and more. Deals so good, you can holiday your way. Only at Target.
Best in Big South coverage, visit BigSouthSports.com. Stay current with the latest news, results, stats, standings, and much more. Enjoy a video feature showcasing remarkable student-athletes. Or connect to school sites or social media outlets all for one place. Remember, the source for all of your conference information is BigSouthSports.com. Find the best variety of officially licensed merchandise and conference and school-branded items at BigSouthStore.com. Gear up with some new apparel or find that perfect gift. Get fully equipped for all of your game day fun at BigSouthStore.com. Halftime here at the Templeton Center. Elon, a 35-28 lead over Presbyterian. Let's see how we got here. Here are your first half highlights. Started off bad for Presbyterian. They didn't score for almost 6 minutes, I believe, or 4 minutes and something in the game. And the shooting was just bad, really bad. But then things started to pick up, and Presbyterian hit some big shots from outside about midway through the first half that helped keep them in this game. But Elon would get some big shots of their own. You'll see those coming up here in just a few minutes. But here's the three-pointers that have helped keep Presbyterian in this one. Presbyterian shooting 42.9% from outside, but Elon shooting just a touch better. 42% from the field, 12 of 18, while Presbyterian just 8 of 27 from the field, and it has helped extend this Elon lead to 35-28 here in the first, at the half. As we see Elon, big shots. Doing a lot of work inside as well. Things getting a little chippy at times inside between Owen McCormack and Elon Sam Sherry. And here are your first half stats brought to you by First Citizens Bank, Forever First. You see the percentages for both of these teams from the field, from outside. Both teams shooting pretty decent. Just a few turnovers, not too bad on the turnover side, five apiece. Rebounds pretty even. Big difference points off turnovers. Elon able to take advantage of those five Presbyterian turnovers for 13 points, where Presbyterian just 5 points off of turnovers in the first half. So we get you ready for the second half here from Presbyterian College. Elon has a 35-28 lead on the Blue Hose here as we head to the half on ESPN+.
Foul too big.
What?
To know that when Wingstop set out to make a crispy, juicy chicken sandwich, they wouldn't make it in just one flavor. They'd make it in all 12. Like lemon pepper, mango habanero, hickory smoked barbecue, and OG hot. So why have one new favorite chicken sandwich when you can have 12? Try the new chicken sandwich for only $5.49 at Wingstop, where flavor gets its wings.
Who come to Cricket, stay with Cricket.
Cricket is easy, it's affordable, customer service is top-notch. That's why I've been with them for so long.
With all that, I'd stay a while too. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Sixers make a statement. The Nuggets battle to stay up top. And the Lakers prove they're a contender. Warriors, Sixers. And Nuggets, Lakers. Tomorrow on ESPN.
Don't try to find me. Find somebody else.
Back here with you at the Templeton Center Presbyterian College as we get ready for the second half between Elon Phoenix and the Presbyterian College Blue Hose. Elon, a 35-28 lead here at the half as the lunch coolers roll out. We start the second half. Elon will start with the basketball here in half number two. Hollering, lob pass inside. They'll get it to share. We got a whistle and a foul. Underneath the basket as McCormack goes to the floor. And the foul is on McCormack. His second. So we'll take another look at that here. Watch after the pass here. McCormack gets caught up off his feet. Court pass, three-point attempt, off the mark, no good. Barnett gets the rebound and draws the foul. It'll be on number 22, Millay Pratt.
That's his first and the team's first.
Freshman out of Columbus, Ohio. Reddish Roan back in the game the first time in a while. Had few fouls in the first half that sent him to the bench. McCormack going to attempt a three, in and out, no good. Rebound underneath, but then they're going to call a foul on Trayvon Reddish Roan. Underneath, let's take a look at that one. Tough call. Tough call. Hollering on the offensive end for Elon. Nord. And got another whistle away from the ball. Now it's going to be on Crosby James. Inbound pass comes in to Sherry. He'll hand it back to McKinnon. McKinnon across, pass knocked away, and then it's going to be out of bounds. Last touch by R, who's grabbing his leg. Point attempt, Halloran from the corner. Sean Halloran knocking down the three. And it's a 10-point advantage here early in the second half for Elon. James across the baseline, comes back up top to McCormack. Marquise Barnett for three. And Barnett knocks down the three. His first points of this ballgame. Sherry picks up his dribble, passes off to Nord. Nord inside. Loses his feet from under him. It's called slippers. Nord shot up, rattles out. And Ard has the rebound. Barnett up top. Thought about the three, but instead goes inside. He'll throw it back out to Crosby James. James for three off the back iron, no good. Rebound out long to Reddish Rome. Toss it off to Barnett, now back to James. Presbyterian offense resets, 12 to shoot. James is going to go inside, puts up a floater. It's good. Crosby James hits the jumper. And Sean Hollerin went to the floor. Gets up holding his head. And wanted a foul call, but didn't get it. And got a whistle away from the ball again. This one going to be an offensive foul on Sam Sherry. And that's Sherry's third foul, as you see. The three-pointer there from Hollerin, and then the answer on the other end by Marquise Barnett. Back-to-back three on back-to-back possessions. Coach Billy Taylor didn't look too happy about that foul on Sam Sherry that puts him on the bench with three personals. Here early in the second half as Hollerin nearly gets the steal, steps on the line out of bounds. Still looking for his first points of this ball game as well. As Marquise Barnett loses that one inside, going the other end is Nord. Goes inside, has it swatted from behind by Barnett. Still able to track it down, and then a slam. A dunk by the big man, number 33, John Bowen III. Gets the big dunk. Side has that shot partially blocked, and then Ard's shot is no good. He goes to the floor and draws the foul. As we take another look at this block by Marquise Barnett that ends up leading to a slam dunk by Elon and a 7-point advantage for the Phoenix. 40-33, 15-51 to play in the contest on ESPN Plus.
There's over 450 million hoopers out there. One will outscore the country and put Norman on the map. Less than 1% of high school players get a scholarship. Odds a freshman will lead the nation in points and assists? One and never been done. 1.3% of college players get drafted. Only one will drop 48 and 11 in the conference finals. One will know this is just the beginning. Trey had a 1.5 billion chance to get here, but he saw a possibility.
The B1 Performance Patch elevates physical functions by transforming carbs into glucose used to fuel the body. Don't compete without it. Visit 5b1.com or on social media at B1 Patch.
There's not a secret to what actually happens behind the scenes at a bank. Here at First Citizens, we're trying to educate the client in each step of what's actually going to happen and actually have them make the educated decision around what steps and what options they utilize. We want to become that trusted advisor that actually guides them down that road, helping you reach your goals. That's Forever First.
Citywide to countryside. Whatever you drive, wherever you go, Hercules Tires has the value, selection, and industry-leading protection to get you there, no matter where the road takes you. Hercules Tires. Ride on our strength.
Seven-point advantage for Elon, 40-33, 15-51 left to go in this contest. And there is, again, Sean Halloran, who is no longer the leading scorer for Elon, as McKinnon has taken over that that spot today. 11 points to Halloran's 8.
At the line shooting 2, Terrell Ard Jr.
Terrell Ard goes to the free throw stripe. And there is McKinnon. 11 points thus far. It's Ard's second free throw goes down and pulls PC to within 6. PC is going to get back in this game. They're going to need big second halves from Marquise Barnett and Trayvon Reddish-Rohn, who have been quiet thus far as Nord takes a 3 off the mark but gets his own rebound. Toss it out. Irvin has it. He'll shoot a 3 and he'll bury it. It into Barnett just a little bit too high and out of bounds.
Kobe Stewart. Houston Jones
checked back in for Presbyterian. Comes into Halloran. We got another whistle away from the basketball. And are they going to get Reddish rolling again?
PC foul on number 23, Trayvon Reddish rolling.
They will, and that'll be his fourth.
Checking in for the Blue Hose, number 10, James.
And Reddish Rohn will head to the bench, and LaVorn will check in. Irvin has his pass, has his shot blocked. Pass comes into Hollering. Ward up top. Back to Hollering. Hollering way across court. Irvin for 3. Rattles it all the way down. And the lead back to 12 for Elon. Tries to answer at the other end. Can't get it to go, and it was last touched by Presbyterian. So Elon basketball. Going up and getting the shot to go is Irvin now really settling in scoring wise. He has 8 points in the game for Elon. Zach Irvin, the senior out of Gate City, Virginia. One pass out to McCormick. McCormick for 3. Off back iron, no good. Rebound by Barnett. And the putback is good as Marquise Barnett gets his 5th point of the contest. .48-36. Still a 12-point lead. throws one up toward the hoop. It goes out of bounds. Back to Presbyterian. Irvin trying to make a little something happen there. Just a little bit too far away from the hoop and then had nowhere to go with the basketball. Tried to draw the foul. Stewart inside, goes up off the glass and good. Kobe Stewart. And a bucket for Presbyterian to pull him back within 10. The lead was 14 just a minute ago. Hollering for Elon. Inside to Sherry. Sherry gonna draw the foul. Give that foul to Kobe Stewart.
Foul.
And Stewart's
three,
second
Kobe
foul.
That's his second and the team's fifth.
And the team's fifth, and there it is.
At the line, shooting two, Sam Sherry.
Sam Sherry heads to the line. Sherry one for two today from the free throw strike. Gets the first.
Subbing in for Elon, number 22, L.A. Pratt.
Pratt checks back in for Elon. Sherry misses the second. Marquise Barnett with the rebound, fires ahead. To James LaVorn. LaVorn will allow the offense time to set up. Going inside, they're going to whistle and call an offensive foul on Presbyterian on Kobe Stewart. That's his third. Under 12 minutes to play here in this contest. An 11-point advantage for Elon. Looking to build upon that lead here. Hollering inside to Sherry. Sherry off the glass and gets the bucket. And it's a 51-38 lead. Jones steps over, takes a three, and he knocks down the tray. Houston Jones with another big three-pointer gives him 6 points in this contest. He's 2 of 3 from outside today. To pass over. A three-point on the other end to try to answer is no good by Pratt. Presbyterian has the rebound. Barnett for three. In and out, no good. Elon with the rebound. Pratt going the other way. Pratt tosses it out to Watson. Watson up top to Sherry. Pratt going to back it out. Over to Hollering on the right side. 10 to shoot. Hollering goes inside. Comes back out to Irvin. Irvin steps over. Takes a three. No good. Barnett with the rebound for Presbyterian. Presbyterian trying to get it within single digits here with just over 10 minutes left to play. Barnett inside to McCormack. McCormack back down in the corner to LaVorn. LaVorn for three. No good off the iron. Rebound underneath by Elon. And throws ahead to Watson. Watson for three from the corner. Off the iron, no good. Stewart to the other side to Jones. McCormack gets it to Barnett. Jones for three from way outside. Hits the front of the rim, no good. A whistle and a foul underneath on the rebound. And it'll be on Elon. It'll be Presbyterian ball when we come back. 9:36 left to play in this one. A 10-point ball game here at the Templeton Center. Elon on top.
Just 10 seconds left. Martinez. The crowd is going wild. The defense applies some pressure. He passes to Luka, who passes the rock right back.
You're the boss.
He steps back, releases a three. Martinez does it again.
Rated E for everyone.
Our Fairbanks, Alaska store is closest to the North Pole, which has folks wondering, does Santa shop at the Home Depot?
No comment.
No comment.
No comment. There's a lot of Knicks in this town.
Somebody made the naughty list.
These tiny gloves are the most popular. We don't know why.
It's elves.
Come on, Bryce.
Find everything you need to make the holidays yours, and maybe Santa?
Santa, I'm Keith.
At the Home Depot, how doers get more done.
I've never seen a big guy wear flip-flops.
I'm stoked for this game.
Yeah, look at the size of that line, though.
Okay.
Nice.
The game has never been better. That is hockey.
.936 left to play. A 10-point advantage for Elon. Presbyterian trying to get it within single digits. Here with 9:36 left to play, it is Presbyterian basketball. Owen McCormick, the leading scorer for the Blue Hose with 9. Over on the other side, it's McKinnon with 11. In the shoot. Cormack from the corner for three in the face of number 33, John Bowen. And Presbyterian has pulled within single digits. Just a 7-point advantage for Elon. Under 9 minutes to play. Presbyterian's been able to get it close a couple of times. Getting it as close to one about midway through the first half. That shot no good. Thrown ahead to Barnett. Barnett going to make a move, go inside. It gets the shot to go. And Presbyterian is within 5. Floater good by Sean Hollerin. That'll quiet the Presbyterian crowd down just for a second. .53-46 inside. McCormack goes up, gets the bank. Owen McCormack, he now is in double figures with 14. Hollering, guarded by James. Passes off to McKinnon. McKinnon loses it off his foot underneath. It's going to be a kick ball, and it's going to belong to Presbyterian. With 7:34 left to play, to be Presbyterian ball when we come back. 53-48. Elon with the lead. Presbyterian trying to claw back here on ESPN Plus.
Hometown Ticketing makes it fast and easy to buy tickets on your school's website or in the new Hometown Fan app. It's simple. Just search for your school, buy your tickets, and they'll be right there in your account, ready to be scanned when you get to your event. Download the Hometown Fan app today.
At one time or another, nearly every family in the Lakelands has been touched by Self Regional. Our family physicians and specialists, nurses and specially trained staff provide care at locations throughout the area, so there's always quality health care close by. It's health care the way it should be, a complete network of care for you and your family. We call it Health Care Connected.
There's over 450 million hoopers out there. One will outscore the country and put Norman on the map. Less than 1% of high school players get a scholarship. Odds a freshman will lead the nation in points and assists? One and never been done. 1.3% of college players get drafted. Only one will drop 48 and 11 in the conference finals. One will know this is just the beginning. Trey had a 1.5 billion chance to get here, but he saw a possibility.
The B1 Performance Patch elevates physical functions by transforming carbs into glucose used to fuel the body. Don't compete without it. Visit buyb1.com or on social media at B1 Patch.
A five-point game with 7:34 left to play in the contest here from the Templeton Center. Presbyterian trying to get back in this one. Marquise Barnett, 7 points here in the second half to help the Presbyterian College Blue Hose get back in this. Owen McCormick with 14. He leads all scorers. Sean Hollerin for Elon, the leading scorer, with 13 points in this contest. Back to action here. Under 7.5 minutes left to play at the Templeton Center on this Thursday afternoon. Jones for three. It's good. Houston Jones knocked down to three. And we got us a 2-point ball game with just over 7 minutes left to play. Bounce it in. Come back outside. Five seconds to shoot. Bowen a third for three. No good. Ard with the rebound underneath. Presbyterian with a chance to tie or take the lead on this possession. Down in the corner. Barnett going to go inside. Toss it back up top to Ard. Ard going in, puts the shot up. It's good, but they're going to call the foul offensive, so the basket won't happen. The offensive foul on Terrell Ard Jr. And let's take another look at that, see if you agree with the man in stripes. Could have went either way, but maybe the feet were set. Take the points off the board, 53-51. Will that be a momentum-shifting call in this contest? Irvin to Nord, 5 to shoot. Nord going inside. Puts one up high off the glass, no good, but an offensive foul called on A-line. So back-to-back possessions with offensive foul calls with 5:58 left to play.
That's his first and the team's fifth.
Reddish roll. Over to Jones. Working it back inside to Ard. Ard goes up off the glass and good. And we're tied at 53 apiece as we head toward 5.5 minutes left to play in Clinton, South Carolina. We got us a brand new ball game. Hollering. Underneath, they'll go inside to Sherry. He'll put it up off the glass and good. And back on top go the Phoenix. Presbyterian folks wanted a travel from Sherry. Didn't get it. Reddish roll. Draw the foul is going to be on Hollering.
That's his third and the team's sixth.
British Rome takes the inbound pass. Other end, the whistle, and they're going to call a foul on Terrell Ard, and Presbyterian players, fans, and everyone that disagree with that call. Let's take another look at it here. Not a lot of contact there. Maybe a clean block, but Nord going to go to the line. The back of the rim, no good. Taking another look. I don't know where the contact was. Your guess is as good as mine. Second free throw goes. It's a three-point advantage for Elon. 4:29 left to play. Couple of questionable calls down the stretch here. Point attempt from the corner for the tie. No good. Rebound underneath. There's going to be a whistle and a foul. It's going to go against Elon's number 11, Nord. Let's take a look at it here. He reaches up and impedes Owen McCormack. The contact there. 1-1 for Owen McCormack. Pretty good free throw shooter. He makes the first. Take a media timeout while the referees are coming over to the monitor. We'll tell you what that's about when we come back. Two-point game here on ESPN Plus.
Did you know one of Nissan's EVs survived the North Pole? And one can go 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds. And they're all emission-free. But don't get an EV for the E. Get it because it pins you to your seat. Sparks your imagination and takes your breath away. Nissan EVs aren't just electric. They electrify you.
A promise is a trust not to be broken. Whether spoken with an oath or sealed with a pinky, USAA started with a promise to take care of the military community. And 100 years later, that's still our mission. Always.
Slow.
Mom?
Wow. And we'll check them both for free.
Yes.
Fix Finder, the most complete free warning light report backed by technician verified fixes.
It's NBA Christmas Day, beginning at noon on ESPN and ABC.
And your guess is as good as mine as what's going on. The referee came over. He looked at the replay monitor, didn't watch anything, turned around and walked back. They had a discussion with the clock operator, but nothing changed. And then there were, I don't know. Is that our, guess that was just our under four media timeout? I'm not sure. And we're not going to get any kind of explanation. Nobody took a timeout because the timeouts haven't changed on the board. So, no idea. No idea. But what I know what we do have is a two-point ball game with 4:13 to go, 56-54. With Owen McCormick with one more free throw coming. And he gets it. It's a one-point game, 56-55. So a weird stoppage in play there. Now back at it, McKinnon up top, gonna go inside and trying to toss it back out. Knocked away by Presbyterian out of bounds. It'll stay with Elon, and they're gonna take another media timeout. We'll be right back here on ESPN Plus.
PC fans, we would like to take a moment to show our appreciation for our...
Just 10 seconds left. Watch it now. The crowd is going wild.
The defense applies some pressure. He passes to Luka, who passes the rock right back.
You're the boss.
He steps back. Release with a three. Martinez does it again.
Rated E for everyone.
Is a personalized ad. It helps you find good ideas. This is Jada, who found one. And here's Greg, badly in need of a good idea. You see, you can discover a small business at any moment. Oh, look, it's that moment when a good idea helps make a moment a better moment. You get the idea. Good ideas deserve to be found. Personalized ads help you find them.
Grandma, how wide are two reindeer?
27, 28, 29.
Make this December one to remember. Together. Happy holidays from Lexus.
Whoa.
line looking to inbound as we're back here at the Tivoli Center Presbyterian College. Hollering up top, five to shoot. Going to go inside, put up a floater. High off the glass, no good. Rebound loose on the floor. And it'll be shot clock violation is the call by the official. The shot clock reset and shouldn't have, which would be correct because that ball was high off the glass and never came close to touching the rim. So a shot clock violation is the call, and it'll give the ball to Presbyterian. 1 point game, 3:41 left to play. Here from the Templeton Center. Elon has led the entire contest. Presbyterian would look for their first lead of the game if they can score here. Owen McCormack for three again, and it isn't. Owen McCormack now with 19 points in the game and gives Presbyterian their first lead with 3:18 left to play. On the offensive end, Hollering, who has been really good today with 13 points of his own, has it knocked away, throws it up as the shot clock getting ready to expire, and it's off the front of the rim, no good, and then the ball knocked out of bounds by Elon. Presbyterian basketball, 2-point lead, 2:49 left to play. Wrong. Barnett, who's been good here in the second half for Presbyterian. Gets it down to Ard. Ard going to go inside. Challenge the defense. Tosses it back out. Jones for three. Off the iron, no good. But Barnett with the rebound. The putback is good. Marquise Barnett with his ninth point of the game extends the Presbyterian lead to four. Two minutes left to play. Elon with the floater. In and out, no good. Presbyterian has the rebound, and there's the foul by number four, Sam Sherry. That'll send Trayvon Reddish Rome to the line with 1:55 left to play. That's Sherry's fourth foul. We take a look here. McCormack from the corner for three. Gives Presbyterian the first lead of the game. And this one by Marquise Barnett that extends the Presbyterian lead to four. And now Trayvon Reddish Roan looking to extend that lead even more. And he gets the first. And that is his first point of the game, coming with 1:55 left to play. Presbyterian lead is now six. A two-possession game for the Blue Hoses. That pass comes inside, stolen away by Barnett. He'll go underneath. He'll get fouled, and he's going to the free throw line. So a bad couple of minutes here for Elon. Just continues to get worse on the turnover. And Presbyterian. Elon going to take a timeout. They have one remaining with 1:53 left to play, and the lead is six for Presbyterian. Great comeback by the Blue Hose, fueled by Owen McCormack's 19 points and big help from Marquise Barnett, who has 9 points, although those 9 points coming here in the second half of play. Presbyterian trying to hold on for a win here this afternoon at the Templeton Center. Trying to get to 3-9. Ahead of a matchup coming up on Tuesday night against Allen, which would be their final non-conference game of the season. His conference play starts December 29th. Right here at the Templeton Center versus the Campbell Camels as Marquise Barnett goes to the line. For Elon, they got a matchup coming up later this week at Valparaiso as Barnett knocks down the free throw. They also will go to Indiana on December the 20th. So a couple of games, one at Valparaiso and one at Indiana coming up for Elon as Barnett misses the second free throw. Rebounds, he'll tip around. Barnett going to come away with it. A huge rebound for Presbyterian. Up 63-56. Eight to shoot. It's a whistle and a foul. So Trayvon Reddish rolling, going to go to the line with a chance to create a little more distance for Presbyterians. That ball just kept tipping around, and eventually Barnett said, I think I'll get it. Reddish rolling goes to the line. 2 points so far, both of those coming from the free throw stripe just a moment ago. Leaves that one a little short. Second on the way and good. And the lead is eight. Attempt by Irvin, no good, but the tip back by Sherry underneath is good. And we got a whistle and a foul. Reddish wrong, going to be fouled and head to the stripe against that foul on Halloran.
That's his fourth.
Three corner, of course, no good, but then the put back right back by Sherry in the right place at the right time.
At the line shooting
two, Trayvon Reddish-Rohn. So two free throws coming for Reddish-Rohn. One more coming for Reddish-Rohn. Big free throws here. Down the stretch, he makes a second. Halloran to Irvin. Irvin for three. In and out, no good. Reddish rolling with the rebound. Knocked out of bounds. And it will stay with Presbyterian with 1:01 left to play. 7-point lead for the Blue Hose. BC gets some shooters out on the floor. Expecting to shoot free throws from here on out. Inbound pass comes into McCormack. Bounce back to Barnett. Head to McCormack. They'll get over here and they'll foul Owen McCormack. We'll go to the free throw strike. 53.2 seconds left to play.
And the line shooting two, Owen McCormack.
McCormack's first is good. The lead it 8-4. Presbyterian with one more coming for McCormack. Second, ball straight down. And the Presbyterian lead is 9. Hollering goes inside. His underhand floater will fall. It's a 14-4 run for Presbyterian over the last 3.5 minutes. That has given the Blue Hose a 7-point lead. Presbyterian going to take a timeout with 42.2 seconds to go. As you look at this one by Halloran. Hold it off the fingertips. So a 7-point game. It's a three-possession game of 42.2 seconds to go. Presbyterian going to try to close this one out, something they've had trouble doing so far this season. See if they are able to do that here this afternoon at the Templeton Center. The Blue Hose basketball out of the timeout. 42.2 seconds left to go. Halloran and Sherry, both for Elon, have 4 fouls apiece. And Sherry is on the court right now. Halloran is not. So Blue Hose to inbound. Comes into Laverne. Got a travel called on Owen McCormack. And Sean Hollering checks back in for this offensive possession for Elon. Elon basketball in front of their own bench, 34.6 seconds to go, trailing by 7. Hollering. Go inside. Fingertip roll. No good off the rim. The shot clock is off, and it's Presbyterian basketball. And there's the foul. As McKinnon.
Elon foul is on number 3, Max McKinnon.
It's whistled for the foul.
And the team is in the bonus.
It's going to send Marquise Barnett to the line for a couple of free throws.
At the line, shooting 2, Marquise Barnett.
Barnett at the line. Makes the first. Second free throw from Barnett. Short. Rebound by Elon. 20 seconds to play. Irvin for 3. He buries it with 15.6 seconds to play, and it's a 5-point game. Take another look at this one.
Timeout, Elon. It is a 4.
Irvin steps over, steps back, buries the 3, and it's a 5-point game. Taking a look at the stats so far, Owen McCormack, 21 points. To lead all scorers in this one, Marquise Barnett has 11 points, but all of those coming here in the second half. Over on the other side, Sean Hollering, 15 points. Sam Sherry has 14, and Zach Irvin now with 11 points in this contest. Hollering, McKinnon, and Sherry all have 4 fouls. Trayvon Reddish-Rome has 4 as well with 15.6 seconds. Left to play, so we still got a little time left in this one, but it is a 2-possession game at 68-65. But the ideal possession there is you let Presbyterian hit their 2 free throws and you come down and get a 3. Time is running out. Presbyterian basketball. See the full court defense from the Phoenix. Presbyterian's had trouble closing out games this season. They'll get the ball inbound to James, and Crosby James going to be fouled with 13.2 seconds left.
Fouls on
Watson, his second.
At the line, shooting two, Crosby James.
Crosby James going to shoot two. Leaves the first one short. Three throws down the stretch. Presbyterian here in this contest, 17 of 31 from the free throw stripe. Missed a couple down here on the stretch. One more coming for Crosby James. Transfer from Anderson University. Makes the second. So a 6-point game with 13.2. Terrell R. Jr. comes back in. Irvin will inbound it to McKinnon. McKinnon across the stripe with about 10 seconds left. Watson throws it away out of bounds. And it'll be Presbyterian basketball with 5.3 left to go.
Number zero, Crosby James. And number 10, James LaVerne.
It's a 6-point game, 5.3 seconds. Inbound pass comes into LaVerne. He'll split the defenders, get it over to McCormack, and that'll do it. Here from Presbyterian College, the Blue Hose get their third win of the season, a 69-63 win over Elon. And here's our Hercules Tire strong move of the game, and it could come from nobody other than Owen McCormick, who that three-pointer from the corner gave Presbyterian their first lead of the game with 3:27 left to play, and they didn't look back in the 69-63 win. That'll do it for us here from Presbyterian College. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. I'm Tyler Sugar. Have a great afternoon, everybody. We'll see you next time here on ESPN+.
Just 10 seconds left. Watch it. Crowd is gone. Wild. The defense applies a pressure. He passes to Luka. Who passes the rock right back.
You're the boss.
He steps back. Release on the three. Martinez does it again.
Rated E for everyone.
PlayStation.
Grandma, how wide are two reindeer?
27, 28, 29.
Make this December one to remember. Together. Happy holidays from Lexus.
At the Home Depot, we have the tools to make holiday magic, especially when it comes to getting the perfect gift. For all those project-doing, technology-loving, holiday-hosting, tool-organizing, woodshop-working people in your life. And gifts for everyone else in between. Only at the Home Depot. How doers get more done.
With Metro.
Imagine even more.
Get a free 5G tablet only at Metro.
This ring is a commitment. After we got married, I got very sick.
He will come every day to help me walk again.
And now I'm back. This is a reminder
that love endures all.
Express your extraordinary love. Jared, love brilliantly.
Live sports. Thousands of live events.
ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals.